Good day, everyone. There was a problem with the Spark Moped 4-stroke scooter. The threads on the spark plugs in the cylinder head were torn off. Alternatively, you can screw it in. Drill a hole and tap the thread in the hole. Next, choose a candle with a larger diameter or screw a homemade threaded bushing onto an old candle. But this is very labor-intensive, since you still have to remove the cylinder head due to the possibility of chips getting into the fuel chamber. It's easier to replace the cylinder head with a new one. It's already 13 years old and has already served its purpose. First of all, remove the carburetor. Side to make it easier to remove the exhaust pipe. Here is the culprit of the repair, the cylinder head and the broken thread in the hole. I have already purchased a new cylinder head, but in order to install it, I need to check the valves for leaks. To check the valves for leaks, I will need kerosene, a syringe, and the cylinder head itself. I pour kerosene into a glass, take a syringe, suck up the kerosene and pour the contents into the inlet valve. Less than 3 minutes later, the intake valve began to leak, which indicates that it is not grounded and is not sealed. You can clearly see how there are leaks. We also check the exhaust valve. As you can see, more than 5 minutes have passed. The exhaust valve is dry, which means it holds tightly. There is no need to grind it in. Now we install the studs with access to the carburetor and exhaust pipe. Actually, the studs are large. The studs are installed, large ones on the carburetor, small ones on the exhaust pipe. The piston is still working, you just need to clean it and degrease it with a solvent. The piston grooves need to be cleaned well and can be reused. Cylinder. Also working, the surface is smooth. There are no scratches, flaws, or damage. Now we check the compression rings. There are two of them. Insert the ring into the cylinder. Optimal gap should be no more than 0.45 millimeters. The ring is fine. We also check the second light brown ring. The 0.4 millimeters feeler gauge does not fit into the gap, which means the ring is fine. Now we begin the installation of the CPG. First we put on the gasket. Next we install the cylinder. I already cleaned it. It was very dirty. Pour a little oil inside the cylinder to make it easier for the cylinder to fit into the piston. Now we put on the cylinder head. First install the gasket, guide bushings. Install the frame. We place the generator bell on the letter T. This is a dead center. Next, we put on the cam's hat so that the holes are parallel to the body and the middle hole is in front. Use an 8 and 10 wrench to tighten two bolts and tighten four nuts crosswise. Set the upper gap to 0.05. The generator is set to the letter T. Now we hold the edge with pliers and tighten the nut with a 9mm wrench. At the end, be sure to check the gap. We also set the gap on the exhaust valve. The gap is 0.1 millimeters. Now install the chain tensioner. Next we put on the housing cover, but before that I install the gasket. Using scissors, carefully cut off the gasket and place it in the groove of the body. Next, I put on the engine housing cover. Don't forget to connect the wire to ground. Thank you all for your attention. Like and subscribe to the channel.